Welcome to Il Palazzo di Lusso, sir.
Welcome to Il Palazzo di Lusso, sir. We just need your signature.
There you are.
Ah, Mr. Holmes. Yes, we have room 221 prepared for you. I see it was reserved for two people. Would you like a second key?
No, I think we'll stick together.
Very good. Rooms are upstairs, sir. Welcome to Cordona.
Hurry up, Sherlock. I want to see our room. I hope there's a balcony with a view.
I apologize, sir, but your room is not yet ready. Perhaps, in the meantime, you would like to relax in the foyer? Tonight, the restaurant is offering a complimentary Marlin ceviche to all our guests.
Let's check what they have on offer. Let's check what they have on offer. Let's check what they have on offer.
Perhaps, in the meantime, you would like to relax in the foyer? Tonight, the restaurant is offering a complimentary Marlin ceviche to all our guests.
Hey, Sherry.
If seafood's not to your taste, everyone loves Benedict's batch. Our poached eggs with hollandaise sauce.
Medium, John, haven't we been through this already?
Come on, it's not like we've got anything better to do.
Excuse me, sir, but I believe...
Why should I sit for a portrait?
Sir, it's art. It doesn't...
Come now, Sherry, what did he do to deserve that?
The servant mentioned ceviche at the bar, Sherry. You should grab us some and I'll find us a table.
I'm starving.
The servant mentioned ceviche at the bar, Sherry. You should grab us some and I'll find us a table.
I'm starving.
Okay, time to check if John found us a nice table for the evening.
If seafood's not to your taste, everyone loves Benedict's batch. Our poached eggs with hollandaise sauce.
Sherry, I'm over.
Cordona's even quieter than I remembered. It's going to be a long evening.
Ah, come now, Sherry. What say we amuse ourselves with a little game?
What were you thinking? Oh, promise me it isn't nonsense. After being cooped up on that boat, I am itching for activity.
No. As you can see, someone left a cane on our table. I simply thought you could identify its owner.
So it is nonsense. It'll take me a minute, John, at most.
Well then, you can deliver it to him as well.
Deliver it to him? Then what a...
Stubborn Sherry, too.
Slapping oneself in the face. The cane is made of ebony, it's worn, uncared for, and bears the scars of numerous hits. A crest depicting a bulb of garlic in a meadow, perhaps the Fielding family. The hand grip is a head of a golden Javanese statue, probably stolen from a temple. The dents suggest it has been used as a bludgeon. This cane is an expensive and ostentatious weapon. Its owner must be vain, volatile, and of noble English blood.
Take it with you, Sherry. Let's return it to its owner. All right, I hope you noted down your observations in your casebook. But how are you going to find this nobleman?
The cane itself is not enough. I may have to ask other guests if they saw who was here.
Mm-hmm.